What's going on, everyone? It's Mike back again, and this is just a little cheeky video, just to talk about Everton and talk about where we are, how well we are, what we're not doing in some people's mind, what players have sort of stood out for me under Dyche, and you know, just be a little bit more positive about where we are. You know, this Everton team. We all know they haven't been great this season, but actually, under Sean Dyche, we've looked like a decent side. You know, a lot was made about this Sean Dyche ball and, you know, this long ball football, rough around the edges, not nice looking, etc., etc. But I've got to be honest, I've thoroughly enjoyed it. I've thoroughly enjoyed more emphasis on getting the ball up the pitch quickly. I've much enjoyed the more directness of it. I've enjoyed the not passing for the sake of passing, not spending 15, 20 passes around your back four. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. And look, Everton have conceded 40 goals this season, but for a team that's 15th in the league, you almost expect that. That isn't horrendous compared to some of the other teams. And where Everton have been let down is in terms of the goals scored, you know, only 23. But before Dyche come in, we were the bottom of the goal scoring charts. And if anyone just checked, you know, we scored a goal from open play in Ellis Sims. We have constantly looked a threat from corners and set pieces, and we actually look like we're going to cause teams problems. I've been really, really happy with Sean Dyche and what he's done. At times, you know, I thought he was killing himself with Neil Maupay, and he was. You know, it was a poor decision starting Maupay. It really was. But once he realised that it was bad, he brings in Tamari Graham. We've looked a different side. We've been much more positive on the ball as well. He's got more energy. He's got more energy and he's quicker. He causes more problems. And what you see now is the front three, or the two players you sort of have seen, you know, in the box or around the box, Dwight McNeil and Gray, they're being supported by a runner into the box like Decore and Onana. And, you know, Decore's got a couple of goals in the last couple of weeks, having not been in the side at all, really, under Lampard. And he's done really, really well. I just think Everton look like a decent side, and I think when you add a striker or two to that next season, you know, I'm more encouraged about where we'll be. We will be difficult to beat. It won't be that stylistic football, but it'll be football that gets results, and we've seen that. You know, Sean Dyche has picked up, what is it, 11 points in out of 24, is it, I think. 3 wins, 2 draws, and 3 defeats. And those defeats, apart from the Villa game, I expect, you know, and I didn't expect us to beat Villa. I expected a point. So we're only 1 point worse off than I actually expected us to be. And we could have got 3 at Forest, and I actually said we'd get a draw. So, you know, we're in a really good position for what he's done coming in. I don't have that fear factor going away from home. You know, when we can go to teams who are very, very good on the ball, like Chelsea are. Look, we know they haven't had a good season to their standards, but they are good. They move the ball quickly. They've got good players. And although we weren't in the game for loads of parts of it, we held our own. We caused some problems, and we got a couple of goals. You know, there was all this thing about the penalty and potentially even on the first shot about, I think it's Kai Havertz potentially being offside. I think it was a penalty, now I've seen it, and I think Kai Havertz was out of the line of sight. I know there's pictures and stills on Facebook, but when I've watched it on telly in real time, yeah, I think he's not really in the way. So I get the two goals. But we scored two goals. We never died. You know, we went up the other end on the 89th minute, and Ellie Sims brushes Koulibaly across and finishes low. You might argue that the keeper probably should have saved it, but we did a really, really good job by just staying in that game, and I'm really, really positive and happy about that. But that doesn't tell the full story. This Everton side, yes, they're conceding goals, but they're scoring. They're scoring, you know. This is, you know, Forest, we conceded a goal, we score. This game, we concede a goal, we score. We're not dying. And when we're at home, we're looking solid, we're looking combative, and we're looking like we can get results. You know, we've got a massive game on Monday night against Spurs. And I truly think we can get 3 points. I really do. I think Spurs are a bit of a mess at the minute, if I'm being totally honest. Everton have also picked up, in the last few weeks, more clean sheets. They've now got 7 clean sheets. You know, them 1-0 wins have been really beneficial. So, yeah, I'm just positive. I'm much more positive. And, you know, people were talking about, you know, what players have we got to come back, and also what signings we'll make in the summer. You know, people are talking about players like Dele Alli. Now, Dele Alli's a gamble for me because, you know, if he plays 20 games, you pay 10 million. For me, he doesn't play next season. And I'm not saying Dyche couldn't get a tune out of him. I'm not even saying that Dyche couldn't make him work harder, because I think Dyche could. I think Dyche could turn him into a player again. But he's not worth the money risk, in my opinion. He's not worth, you know, he could potentially cost you £20 million by the end of next season's campaign. And I don't think he's worth that right now. And I think Dyche will have a look at him in the summer, and he'll really assess what he can do with him. But it wouldn't surprise me if he goes on a free transfer or a loan somewhere else. It's abundantly obvious Everton need strikers. They need goal scorers. They need people who can put the ball in the back of the net. And I do think we'll get one. I'm hoping it's not just going to be in the typical Burnley mould. So I'm hoping that he does go for someone with a little bit more pace. You know, we have got more money to spend, and, you know, we were a very attractive proposition a few years ago, and we're not as much now because, you know, Sean Dyche is not going to bring in the same calibre of player as Ancelotti and even Rafa Benitez and even Frank Lampard. But he'll bring in players that do the right things at the right time, and that's what I'm looking forward to. Players that know their job, can do their job, can create something. You know, we brought in a very decent Maxwell Cornet. He developed a Dwight McNeil who, for a long period of his career at Burnley, looked very, very good. You know, he got the best out of Ashley Barnes. I remember calling Ashley Barnes the Burnley's version of Diego Costa. He developed these players. And, you know, there's no doubt in my mind that Dyche is the right man to stabilise this football club. You know, is he the right man in 3 years' time when Everton have ambitions of potentially European football and maybe, you know, the sale of the club, etc. And the next lofty heights that they want to aim for? Maybe not. But what he is somebody who's going to get Everton to hopefully stay in the league this season, touch wood. I'm much more confident of it now. He's somebody that will hopefully get Everton to not really be in a relegation battle next season. You know, I'd like to say, you know, maybe see us finish 12th, 11th, somewhere like that. But it's really, really positive that Everton are going in the right direction. And I feel it. I feel like the club is. I feel like the protests outside the ground, they've been nothing more than amicable. They've been brilliant. And they've been a real, you know, the directors haven't been at the game. And ever since the directors haven't been at the game, Everton have also played better. And I don't think that's a coincidence either. I really do think that when you put the brass tacks down and you do your write-ups and all that, I think Dyche has made such a significant change to Everton in such a short period of time. It's unbelievable. And, you know, based on the fact that, you know, he's picked up 11 points in 8 games from a team that I couldn't see scoring goals. I couldn't see him staying up. I think he's done phenomenal. There's teams down there that have turned a corner or they've had their purple patches. I think Wolves have looked very decent, and then this week they've had bad moments. I think Forest are banging trouble, if I'm being brutally honest. You know, I'm doing a show tonight called Beat the Drop, and it's actually been organised by Forest fans. Really nice people, but I do worry for their football team. you've got West Ham, who I think have too much quality to go down. I'm still convinced they have too much quality to go down. You've got Southampton and Bournemouth, who are fighting, who can pick up results. There's a lot of teams down there that could get themselves out of it. You know, you literally take three or four wins on a run, and you are not just clear. You're out. You're not going down. Like, it's that tight. So I think it's going to be an excellent end to the season for the neutral. And I don't think it's going to be a bad end to the season for us, if I'm being honest. I really, really hope that we can... I really, really hope that we can do all of the positive things that we need to keep going. I hope that our purple patch lasts a little bit longer than everyone else's. I hope that Everton pick up enough points. But I am confident we'll stay up. And another thing I wanted to talk about was the atmosphere around the club. The fans are much happier. We're much more united. We're much more on side with each other. You know, this Everton side, all of a sudden, it's a case of they're just more positive. And the fans are more positive. You know, I was there at Stamford Bridge. We sang for 97 minutes. You know, the referee tried to give Chelsea as many opportunities to score as they could. And we stayed solid. We stayed together. We were, you know, we were cuddling our fellow fans. We were, you know, we were absolutely rapturous. We were there for 10, 15, 20 minutes after, still singing. It was beautiful. It was exactly what you want to go and watch football for. And, you know, my little boy was really, really happy. I took a friend because there was tickets available. I've never known there to be so many spares for an away game, if I'm being honest. But the Brick were brilliant. So thank you to Brick Travel for organising my ticket and meeting me at the ground. And they were, honestly, they were fantastic. They were great, great people. So massive thank you to them. And we go again. You know, that's all we can do. We go again. We go into these games, and you've got to hope that we can just keep going. We've got this Tottenham game. You've got this weird game, I would say, with Manchester United on the 8th, which, you know, do I sit here and expect anything? Probably not, as of right now. But if you offered me 4 points from Tottenham and Chelsea, I'd take it. Based on the fact we've also beat Arsenal. You know, these were games that I was not expecting Everton to get anything in. And they could potentially pick up, but they've certainly got 4 points, you know, and it'd be beautiful to get another three. So I'm really happy with where we are. And I know there's other podcasts that are doing loads of content, and we're all saying the same things. You know, there's no one shooting out loads of negative comments. There's no one person saying, oh, he's rubbish or he's bad. Or there's a consensus, you know. I really do think this club will be fine this season. And I do think they'll build. And I do think with the fans on side, which they've got, they'll do great. Palace have got 9 of the bottom 10, I think, in their last 12 games, or they've got 8 of the bottom 9. Palace probably will be fine. I find it mad that they have got rid of Vieira, if I'm being totally blunt. And I think they're being linked with Frank Lampard, which, again, I find absolutely mad. But you probably would argue that Palace have got more attacking impetus than we have. Just with the players they've got, Zaha, Elise, Eze, you know, they've got good players. But yeah, I'm positive. And, you know, the other thing, the future's bright. You know, we've got a new stadium on the horizon. It's 50, I think it'll end up being slightly more actually, but 53,000 fans, say, are going to be there supporting the club. It's going to mean more season ticket holders. We're still going to be close to the pitch. You know, there's going to be silly things like a little bit more leg room, and amenities will be better. And, you know, there'll be more pre-game stuff. And this club has got a bright future. It's a sleeping giant. It is. It's a sleeping giant, and what it needs is someone to take it by the scruff of the neck and make it that. And, you know, we've had MSP interested in buying us. We've also had 777 Holding, I think, interested in buying us, the Florida-based company that owns Sevilla, I think it is as well. Now, I don't know if any of those clubs will buy, when any of them groups will buy Everton. But what I do know is that once Everton have got a stadium, they'll be much more attractive. Who knows? Who knows where we end up? You know, my dad and John, they've said for years now, Mark, you'll never see us win a trophy. And I get it. You know, I get it. You know, Everton haven't won anything since 95, and it was a solitary FA Cup. And all of the history in the 80s and the 60s and the whole history of Everton Football Club and, the honours. You know, we sat there. It makes me laugh, actually, because we sit there and we go away to grounds like Chelsea and Manchester City, and we've still won more league titles than those clubs. You know, we have still won more in terms of titles. League titles. But we've fallen on rough times over the last 30 years, 35 years. And that needs to improve. And I think with the right man, right owners, and in long, whether that be Dyche or somebody else, right manager, I think this club will get there because us as fans, we're the right people. You know, we can sit here and analyse performances of whoever we want. We can all sit here and say Iwobi was either good or bad because I've seen completely mixed reviews from this Chelsea game. We can sit here and say Onana doesn't look bothered or he does look bothered. I saw Onana standing there at the end of the game and be blown away by us as Everton fans. And he loves it. He loves this club. He loves it. You can tell. He stood there for 5 minutes. And I think if he could have got his phone out and recorded it and really sucked in that atmosphere, I think he'd have kept that forever. I think that'd be on his Instagram and all his feeds and whatever. And I think we got a bright future. I'm much more happy than now than I was 8 games ago. Let's just say that. Yeah, it's been a bit of a rambler, ain't it? But do you know what? It's just sometimes nice to just be real. Like, you know, I've only been doing match previews and match reactions. And the reason for that is because, you know, there is now so many content creators and so many Everton people out there that they do all this content. And, you know, I don't want to push anything down anyone's throat. I don't need to. When we listen to these 20-minute videos and we record them and I record them and I get, you know, say John on or Millsy, you know, whoever it may be. The reason is it's because I want to give you content that I feel like you relate to or you listen to or you want to. And, you know, I've always had this thing, I'm not a Scouser, and, you know, I still get comments. I got one last night saying, you know, why is it that, I don't know, basically we're saying that I'm a wall and that I shouldn't support Everton. But this club doing well means everything to me. I almost cried on the second goal, like it was there. You know, it wasn't for the fact that it was a draw that I was like, hold it back, Mike. Because the relief when Everton are picking up results these days now at the moment, it means everything. And being able to convey that to you guys and do videos, it means a lot. One of the guys who has supported me for a long, 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 long time, he knows who he is, AJ. He said about me doing more live videos, and I will do that. I'm also tempted, and I don't know what people feel about this, because I also don't like the adverts. I don't like the adverts in the videos, but I have to generate, and I'll be straight, I have to generate some income. And I don't know whether Patreon would be better you know, it's a small fee, but you don't get bombarded with adverts. I don't know. So let me know your thoughts in the comments about stuff like that, guys. And also, let me know what you want. You know, what do you want to see more of this channel? I always said it. It's not about what I create for you. It's about what you want to see. You know, it's noted, more lives. Done. Okay, we'll have more lives. What do you want from me as a content creator? It took a little bit of time to get in the house and get used to it and sort out a few of the things. And obviously, I bought a boom mic. I've not used it today. But this isn't where I want to do my videos. I'm in my dining room. You know, I want the studio, and the studio's coming. You know, we're paying for the garden. There'll be a little bit of a space at the back where we're going to have a studio built. No, it's not a studio. There'll be two chairs, and we're going to try and do some content. I'm trying to find another local football fan and start doing an actual football show as well, a proper podcast that goes out on streams. So I'm trying, guys, and I just want to make sure that you all still know that I love you. I'm very, very grateful for the support and the care and the kindness that you've shown me over the last 4.5 to 5 years. I really am. And we just got to keep going, haven't we? We just got to keep going. And, yeah, just thank you ever so much, everyone. Love for the love, people. And peace.